Hey, everyone.
Hello.
Welcome in to our Armored Core stream. It's me. It's you. We're out of price. And it's this video game, Armored Core 6. Not the Fires of Rubicon, just Fires of Rubicon, right?
Armored Core 6, Fires of Rubicon.
Fires of Rubicon.
There's no the.
But it is the game that we're playing. Huh?
Yeah,
so, we are going to check out Ren's. That's where we're looking at Ren's right now. And then Ren's going to see if she can help fix my mech and see if we can't get through, or at least make some progress on this chapter one boss. I think the problem I'm having truly is less to do. Some of it's me, just me internally, my problems. But also I think we got some mech problems. Ren is going to hopefully help me solve some of those. But like, important, what's with the what's the story? You're a story person. Have I just made it so now that the stream is now going to go on for 7 hours while I get...
No, you haven't.
Okay.
I don't have one. Like, I'm not, like, I have not, I have yet to figure out what my pilot's whole deal is. But, yeah, this is, right now I'm just, like, I've been focused on, like, mechanic stuff because I can't play much further in the game because I'm just gonna plug this real quick.
Yeah, do it.
If you would like to hear me talk more about Armored Core 6, you can do so by watching or listening to Minmax's deep dive series about Armored Core 6, which I'm doing with Jacob Geller and Cyril Vasquez, which I am extremely excited about. But it has also prevented me from playing past chapter one of this game.
Yeah, which, you know what? That's definitely my excuse too. I just wanted to respect the remap discussion that we were gonna have and not go past chapter one because like, I don't want to be talking about things that Ren can't comment on or having seen. And so it was. I felt like I was giving a gift to you and the discourse of the podcast to just say, you know, I could beat this little guy, but I'm just, and it's definitely not that I've been doing this for 90 minutes and seem to be making no progress and I'm fully tilting. No. It's to respect Ren. We had a good question in the chat. Someone asked, even though, you know, you haven't come up with the full story for your pilot, for this mech, they did wonder if the mech, please be nice to Yaz, wondered if the mech has excellent taste in women.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Okay. Always. So that's a bare minimum.
Yeah. Sorry, actually, before we start this, I just want to show off how, I noticed this right before the stream, I want to show off how good the animations are on these legs. They are sumptuous. They are. No,
classic phrase used for mech designs. Look, sumptuous.
Look at that.
The kinds of things that people want to do to a mech that they call sumptuous. That I don't know if we can do that on Twitch.
That's just really impressive animation. Look at that. Look at how fucking sick that is, dude. Look, you can see the individual joints and like reverse jointed legs moving. That's so fucking cool. Are you kidding me? Now to show you how this thing moves.
Yeah, describe. Does the mech have a name? Like, you have to give a name at the start. Is that part of your process, or
currently this mech is titled is just called White Raven, despite the fact that it is mostly pink. Because fun fact, if ravens get like the pigmentation that makes them white, they also have like pink accents.
Interesting.
But yeah,
Ren is playing this on, both of us are playing on PS5. I saw earlier today that, because Armored Core 6 is built on the same tech that has powered a number of From Software games, including most recently Elden Ring. Apparently the trick that was true of Elden Ring is also true of Armored Core, which is that if your concern is frame rate, the best way to play this game is to play the PS4 version on PS5, and that will give you the most stable version of the game. Now, I'm less of a technically inclined or bothered by technical like hiccups than I know you are, Ren, and who is like much more sensitive to frame rate. Have you had any issues playing like the native PS5 version?
This game plays fucking smooth as butter to me.
Okay.
If you see any stuttering, it's because I am, it's like from my OBS preview. So Patrick, I have a feeling, which is that you're going to be pissed about how this mech moves because you're going to want these legs.
All right.
So this is my forward boost.
Yeah. That's pretty
cool. So if
cool.
I'm touching the ground, the way that reverse jointed legs work is that if they're touching the ground, they give you an extra boost when you're moving. So this is my jump.
Oh, wow. You're just up there.
Yeah, so this is my... And then if I do a dash from the ground, I use the legs to kick off the ground to do that.
Do these legs cost like $200,000? Is that like what we're looking at here?
Yeah. Also, I have a pile bunker, which is basically, it's the thing from the trailer with the big spike. But yeah, this is, for folks who have not played this game at all, this is the chapter one mission that I am trying to give Patrick a mech that can handle.
Yeah, so there are, chapter one of the game is a handful of hours long, like 4 to 6 probably, depending on how you're skating through the game, how much time you're spending going back and doing, you know, missions multiple times in order to, like, if you do the missions well, where, like, you're not wasting a ton of ammunition, you're fighting a decent amount of grunts, you will still not have nearly enough money to purchase all the parts in the game. There is definitely a grind associated with doing that. Now, arguably, part of the quote grind is going to be you trying out new parts in like older missions you've already done, maybe experimenting with your mech in a way that has less pressure associated with it because you're doing the mission for a second time. I haven't done any of that. This is like a game where I believe I mentioned this on the podcast, Ren, where it's like if I could just turn off, like just give me unlimited money, I probably would. This is also a game that if they said for $30. You can just have enough money to buy everything in the game as an extra piece of DLC. I'd do it. I want to be exploited by this game so that I don't have to do the grind. How have you found the actual grind stuff? Do you have you try to do something different in the mission, or is this put on a podcast, listen to something, and get to the other side?
So the thing about S-ranks is that you can't, if I'm remembering correct, you can only like restore from checkpoint like one time. And so basically if I have had to run these missions a bunch of times to S rank this specific mission. And so I have played a lot of this particular mission is what I will say.
Have you been trying
to
S rank
for parts to my knowledge? Yes, I have. My goal is to S rank everything in chapter one.
Oh, so like when Ren is given the limitation box of you can only play the first chapter, the response to that is, well, I will simply S rank all the missions in chapter one.
That is exactly what has happened, Patrick.
Thanks to everyone subscribing. I saw much earlier. Let me see if I can roll up and find it. Oh, I missed it. It might have been way earlier in chat, but there was an anonymous gifter that gifted a bunch of subs. So much thanks to whoever that was for doing that to the folks that got it. Not that Will Smith. I mean, if someone tells you you're not something, your first reaction is going to be, what aren't you telling me, not Will Smith? But I believe you, Will Smith. Thank
Sorry,
you for
I'm doing this mess
because
I'm doing this fight real messy. Sorry
it's,
about that.
Oh, it is very easy to slip from doing something very slick in this game to just looking like a complete ass.
it's one of my favorite things about it, actually.
All right. And also thanks to Regulus117 for subscribing.
Oh, you fucker. So, Patrick, actually, you know what? I'm just going to let you see how much damage that does in a minute.
Which one? That thing?
That, yeah.
So there's several melee weapons in this game. The one that the game starts you with, the one I've stuck with so far, has been the sword. Why did you switch to the pile driver? What drove you to switch to away from the sword to that?
So the pile bunker, basically, if I charge it and I land a hit, I will kill an AC. If I stagger someone and then I land this, that AC is dead. They're gone. They're in hell forever. And so that is why I switched to it. You'll see also when I hit the when I hit the enemy that we're about to fight in here.
Hey, before you get to that fight, can you walk us through? Because sometimes it's hard to tell in the midst of a fight what all your weapons are doing and how you're thinking about how they work in concert. I wonder if it's worth like heading back out into the open area and just sort of show people like how these all work and how you're thinking about them.
I can just explain on the way to the encounter. So basically, I have this mech uses three primary like guns. One is a handheld SMG or machine gun. That's this. That is used to apply as much stagger damage as possible. This is going to be the thing that I'm going to be firing most consistently. If I take my finger off of the right trigger during this fight, then something has gone wrong. The second one is similarly a rapid fire SMG style thing. The difference being that this one is designed to take off the shield, the pulse shield that the boss uses.
I'm starting to wonder if that is one of potentially many, but that may be a critical solution. Like that. Okay. All right. Continue. Sorry. Continue about your mech, but I'm taking notes.
No, you're good. and then this is these are called the songbirds, Patrick.
Oh. Did you name them that? Is that your...
No.
Okay.
This is the game's name for them.
That's great. That's a great name.
It's basically a shoulder-mounted grenade cannon that does a metric fuck-ton of damage, both to posture and, like, traditional health. They are incredible. I love them very much. And then finally, we have this. Which is basically what I use for finishers, or if an enemy has really high posture, one hit from that will fix that very quickly.
Okay. Because this chapter one boss, which we talked about this game before, I'd read a lot about the game, the reviews, some of the guides coverage, just like you can kind of get a sense of like what were the points that you were having trouble with, and where does that fall in with everyone else? And I was just so delighted to read a bunch of like, oh, that chapter one boss is a fucking asshole. And I was like, oh, thank God. Wow, you just tore through that shield. Holy shit. Okay, now granted, let's be clear. Ren has run through this mission. How many times do you think, Ren, at this point?
I don't think I need to answer that.
No, we need a ballpark. Like, so in a standard baseball game, you know, you got about 9 innings. You got 7 innings, 7 inning stretch. Are we, like, how many baseball games are we at? At this point,
I would say this is okay. Well, that was very silly. I got hit by that.
Let me. Okay, hold on. So, higher than 20.
I would say so. I mean, like in terms of how many times I've also played through it to get the S rank. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Did you get the S rank?
Yes, I did.
Okay. With this build?
I believe it was actually my tetrapod one. But this one does fine. This one actually, I think, is better than the build that I used to take it out to get the S rank.
Wow, so you're managing to get the health down this far before it even hits phase two, basically.
It actually did hit phase two. It just went so quickly that you missed the animation.
Oh, well, some of us like to luxuriate in getting to the fire of phase two. Knowing that they're about to be destroyed.
So, Patrick, I actually have advice relating to that fire phase.
Mm, uh-huh. There's not even the advice. I mean, I will take the advice. The problem being, I've only just been getting to it. And then it's like one of those things where, you know, you play a soul-style boss. It's like, yes, made it to the next phase. And then immediately, like, kerplunk, like, whack. And then it's like, well, I didn't learn anything in that phase. I just died immediately.
Yeah, no, it's definitely, until you, like, learn it, this boss is a motherfucker. This is, like, a very hard check for, do you want to play this video game, like we said on the pod.
But wow, so now you're seeing some of the phase two stuff with the fire. But the little jump, for this boss specifically, the jump that you're getting is doing, because the sheer speed at which this boss pinballs around the screen is a huge part of what is a challenge at times with it. And so your ability to kind of close the gap so quickly seems like it is doing a lot to help you deal with it, which is interesting.
Yeah, I mean, that is the thing about this, is that, again, gap closing is my specialty.
And wow, that bubble weapon just rips through the
shield. It's really good. What a good boss fight. What a sick fucking fight. What a sick fight. So yeah, that is how this mech works. Patrick, we are going to make a slightly modified version.
The playing will be, let's call it slightly modified. Is that the words we're using?
Oh god. Yeah. That's the words we're using.
That's the words we're using. Do you want to show, go to the parts shop, maybe walk through some of the other, yeah, like, what are the other evolutions you've had of this mech,
okay,
in particular?
So, the original version of this mech, let me hop over to my, here, let me just save this version real quick.
Ah, so you can do that. I haven't gotten far enough down, like, caring about builds to, but you can just do presets, right? So you can just, yeah, kind of swap between them. Gotcha. Which, by the time you get to end of chapter one, kind of, even if you aren't grinding, you're going to start getting enough parts that you might be wanting. So what's the difference here between...
So this is the version that I actually beat this boss the first time with. Mm. And this is the V1, which is what I used for my first playthrough of Chapter 1, was the V1 version. And so the difference between V2 and V1 is... let me hop into the assembly. One, this uses tetrapod legs, and tetrapod legs are really good because they don't have much recoil. That's advantage one, is that they have basically zero recoil. So you don't have to enter, like, the cool shoot stance to shoot your charged weapon.
Yeah, like, for the one of the weapons I was using a lot during chapter one was a laser rifle, which has, like, just kind of a pew, 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 and it's cool, and it does decent damage, and you can fire it pretty often. But, like, if you hold and charge it, what your mech does is like a cool shooting stance where it pauses and like, wow! And it looks sick, but also you can also get your ass handed to you as a result of that.
Okay, there we go. Okay. So yeah, basically the way that this mech works is it relies on its boosters to basically hover over someone and then just irritate the shit out of them. Look at this thing.
It seems like...
Look at this idiot.
Seems made for PvP to just really annoy. So, like, having somebody hover above you.
Yeah, it's real fucking irritating, but it's also very good at the thing it does. That laser blade at the end.
Yeah, that's a different sword really than strong. The one you get at the start, right? Like the...
Yes. Yeah, this is a laser sword as opposed to a pulse blade, which is what you're using, Patrick.
And the laser sword seems like it's more of a, like, it's a wide sweep, so it's doing less damage, but you don't have to necessarily hit the target. Like, your pile bunker, that has to be hit the fucking target. Like, the basic sword has to hit the fucking target. It seems like with that, you get a little more of a sweep to it, so you have a wider window.
So, yes and no. It has a larger cool... It does more damage than this. But, so if you'll notice here, this has two consecutive hits. So this can combo.
Right.
And so technically...
And it has a charge, which I don't use that much, but it does have a charge.
Yes. The charge on the laser blade is the double hit that I was doing.
I see. Oh, gotcha. Gotcha.
Also, it's so great that they let you just swap out parts in the literally in the middle of doing a fight.
The one thing I wish this doesn't apply to me right at the moment because I'm flush out of cash. But I do. The game does. You know, you can swap your AC's parts. You know, outside of a boss checkpoint, right? Like, so you don't have to start a mission over. But
if you have money and you're like, oh, I'd like to buy a part and swap that in, you cannot do that mid-mission. You have to exit out, buy it in the shop, go back to the mission. It's one of those small things that, as long as you're accounting for it, it's not the biggest deal, but it was like a small piece of friction. It was like, ah, I don't really see any reason why the game shouldn't let me purchase a new piece at a checkpoint, but you can't.
Yeah. But yeah, so this is what I used for pretty much all of chapter one. The only thing I don't like about this mech is that the missile system on it, the right back unit, is fucking dog water. The dual missile launcher is absolute dog shit. It's fucking terrible. Really, I don't love any of the missile launchers that I've used so far. They're pretty unreliable.
So you're just kind of spamming them, and if they do something, great. If they don't, you know, no harm, no foul. It's not really based into how you're taking down the enemy.
Yeah, this is, well, yes and no. I need these missiles to hit so I can get the stagger damage that I need to be able to, like, do these fights. What I may swap in for you for this fight would be the plasma missile launcher, and then we would go with the this one because it's for lighter mechs, and then
unfortunately my guess is what's going to happen is you have these grand dreams. I may not have most of these parts, so this is going to be a bit of a, you know, got to work with what we got situation. What has Patrick bought? Well, he's bought a decent amount of guns, but okay, needs to buy more arms and legs probably. But you know what? Sometimes you walk into a home, and this is why we have the HOA pod. Like, the place you're in, the mech you're in, the parts you got are sometimes the parts you got. You can't always have your dream mech. Sometimes the mech you've got is the mech you've got. Or you can grind a mission 25 times and then work your way towards the dream mech.
You also parts sell back for their exact buying price, and so if you decide that you don't like something, you can just sell it back for full price.
Oh, so the currency does not change whatsoever between buying and selling?
No.
That's funny and also a little silly. But okay, so what you're saying is, if we have ambitions, we can go to market. We can figure it out.
Which we should.
Okay, all right. Do you want to make something, like, what's... Do you want to make something real weird with? Because you have a ton of the parts. So I feel like you're just in a good position to show us.
Oh yeah, I can make something weird.
Let's make something weird before we look at mine, and then
weird how, Patrick?
I don't know. Like what? Like that? That seems weird.
You want me to use treads?
You don't seem like you. What do you? Here's the question. What do you not like to use?
Here's the thing. I found that I actually like to use pretty much everything except for missile systems, which I think are a little bit boring.
Okay. Let's do the tank, though. I feel like I haven't seen a ton of the tank and how that, that operates, so let's build a tank, boy.
Okay. Let
tank
me check
girl.
What generators we've got.
What does a generator do? I think that's worth maybe explaining to folks, like, as you're going through the shops. How does a generator impact the mech design?
So it's actually what you basically build everything else around.
Okay.
Patrick, we need to get you a new generator.
Exactly. Yeah, almost certainly. Because you just told me more information than I know about a generator. It's like, it's informing, like, cost, right? Of, like, what you can build around the mech to some degree, right? Like,
so if you look in the bottom right, you'll see this current load, current EN load.
Yep.
That's your generator determines your EN load.
Mm-hmm.
That is what determines it. So right now, we are using the generator with the highest EN load, the highest energy load that we're, like, capable of having. Let me see if there's a better one.
Is there a reason to have... Do generators just get better? Or
no.
Are there... What are the trade-offs between different generators?
So, weight. It's weight. It's also recharge. And so there's two things happening. Your energy recharge rate and your total energy capacity. So for this mech, if we got this extremely expensive generator, which we will.
Okay, I actually have the task in front of you. Someone has come up with it in chat. I want to make sure
the
I credit.
The slowest mech possible?
Bench mob, yes. Let's build the slowest mech possible. Let's just put on that weight. Like, let's just make the biggest boy, the beefiest mech that we can.
I can make that work. FCS booster. Okay, your one absolute slowest?
Yes, because we want to put as much stuff on. We're throwing a party. Like, this is like the frat house of mechs. It's just like, yeah, okay. Like, let's get okay. out there.
Okay, so we're not going to be using that. All right. Highest weight. Okay, highest weight part.
Look at that
Gatling gun.
That Gatling gun is huge.
And then just so we're not using two, we're going to use the second head. Oh, this is the heaviest part. Oh, this is going to be fucking stupid.
Oh, wow. All
right, we're going to have to equip new arms, which is fine.
Because the game won't, these are like hard lines, right? Like, you cannot bring this mech into the field if you if you have those red markers.
All right, let me see what the fucking heaviest one of these is.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah, there it is. Oh, this is awful. This is ugly.
I can't wait.
So, I look at this mech and I say, ugly.
This is probably the first Armored Core game released on PC, right? Like, that has to be true. Or at least the one that is released in a modern environment where I am excited to see what modders do to this game. By all accounts, the Ren, how does this mech make you feel inside?
I hate this device. Now let's try to move it around.
The mech, I'm gonna have to re-download this on Steam because the... Ah, oh, my chunkster! Yay!
Okay, so this is the fast version. This is us boosting.
Mm-hmm. What are those boats that people put on lakes that are really just like floating little castles? What do they call them?
Oh, this sucks, Patrick!
What do they call those boats? I want one day. It's like my dream is to have one of these. A pontoon boat. You have a pontoon boat, a pontoon mech, upon which sits a Gatling gun king.
All right, Patrick, let's test this
Wait,
out.
Wait, can you show me what's the boost on this when you click? What does my boy do?
So it's this. Oh, this?
That, yeah. Yeah! Put on the jet engines! My boy, my pontoon mech is moving!
Here, let's just see how much damage this does. I think it's gonna be a high number. Go.
So is
pretty good.
In this game, like, if you thought this was funny and or interesting as a mech design, I saw someone in the chat say this is essentially a very similar design to something they beat the original Armored Core with. What are the advantages for a heavy mech? Is it purely heavy weaponry? Is it like way more health? Is it stagger? Is like takes way longer to kick in?
Yep.
Okay.
So, Patrick, you'll notice that our attitude stability is 2675.
Uh-huh. What is attitude stability? Is that stagger?
That's your stagger. Okay. That's your stagger meter. So we're gonna try and get that up as much as we can. Wait, also, we didn't equip our back weapon. Oh. So again, looking for the heaviest things we can. I think I know what it is. Okay, so it's this on the right. And then we'll do this on the left. Great. This is gonna be awful. I'm gonna hate using this. All right, let's check our FCS system. This is not what we want to be using anymore. Talbot's probably fine. Fine, it's probably fine. Oh, this is gonna suck.
Okay, Ren, I'm gonna need you to go replay that mission for the 20.
Yeah, no,
time.
I know.
Yeah,
I know what was gonna happen.
I'm gonna need you to fight that boss.
No, I got it. Trust me, Patrick.
Okay,
go ahead. I knew what was about to happen.
You knew what was happening before I knew I was going to request it, which perhaps says a lot about our relationship. Is that you could see that one coming already.
Fucking ugly ass mech. What a stupid fucking contraption. I hate this motherfucker. It's gonna suck.
Groove Mansory, I feel like this thing could use a plow in the front.
Yeah.
If anyone sees you, good luck getting around.
Thanks, Patrick. Hey. No, you didn't.
Who are they with? We
Okay, so while flying, I can still get hit like that. Mm-hmm. But that should kill, right? Oh, no.
You know, I'm sure if you lived in a world where giant robotic creatures were flying around controlled by pilots, like, all of these could be terrifying. But if I saw this motherfucker coming towards me, terrified. He's gonna plow
okay,
my
that
snow,
does good damage.
And he's gonna take me out.
God, this sucks.
brand new stream series, Patrick builds Ren a mech, and then Ren has to try and beat a boss with it.
Oh, Jesus. Miserable. Fuck you, how dare you dodge? Go to hell, idiot. Fuck off. Let me trundle over.
Come on, use the, like, a clamber over the gate there. Like, can't your mech grab on and stumble over? Yeah, keep moving, Ren, with that.
Don't worry, Patrick, I'm definitely moving.
Keep moving that big mech ass of yours. Gotta get it going.
Oh, don't worry. This is as fast as we go.
Steve Farragut, idiot. New series, new mech, who this?
I actually think that's a very funny idea. Good joke. All right. Oh, this is gonna be the worst.
We'll have to revisit this when. So are you? You're at min-max. You're doing it chapter by chapter, right?
Yeah.
Do we know how many chapters are in the game?
This game is 5 chapters and new game plus.
Okay. So maybe once Ren has beaten the game, I promise we will come back and do a new mech who this, and just get Ren to use the full scope of the mech parts in this game.
All right, you fuck off. Like, truly, go fuck yourself, not you. But the second I stagger this dude, it's over.
I was gonna say, yeah.
Yeah, once I get one stagger, this is over.
Yeah, you do just sort of tear through him. You have a lot of slow moving parts that make it difficult on nailing him, but once you get him staggered. Bonk. Bonk.
Fuck off. Idiot.
You know, it's interesting that, you know, it seems like one of the, not trick, but, you know, advantage you can give yourself in this next fight is that bubble gun, and that the fight right before that is an enemy using the bubble gun. Almost, I have to admit, like, when I saw that in the shop, I was like, that's a silly ass looking gun, what do I want to use that for? And then to discover that, well, it's not the skeleton key to this fight, but would give me a useful distinct advantage is tremendously funny. This Mega Man-ass looking weapon that you get from fighting Bubble Man in Mega Man 2 is the key to getting through this. Oh, look at him go. When he doesn't have the boost on and it's just like...
Look at his fall. Felt like a goddamn stone. Okay. I'm glad you're happy.
Look, I gotta get all the enjoyment I can out of this before I actually have to play this game.
Yeah, right? I understand. I understand, Patrick.
Delaying the inevitable.
Here we go. Sup, fucker?
Those machine guns you have do rip through this dude.
Come here, fucker. Come on, come on, come on, come on, line. There we go. All right, we're gonna win this, I think, but it will not be pretty.
Well, again, like, one of the big differences here is, like, you have to do so much more damage to take out the shield, right? Like, yeah, you're spending a lot more time on that shield than you were with your particular build. And frankly, that's essentially what's undercutting a lot of my fight, other than some questionable play, was spending so much time on the shield.
Now I'm just gonna have to tank that. Yeah.
Oh, you're just gonna have to what, Ren? You're gonna have to.
I'm gonna have to tank it.
You're
gonna
have
to tank
it.
That's fun.
Yeah. The old meta. This is the boss the Kotaku article is about, right? Yes. There are two, like, notable skill checks in this game. One happens in the tutorial. And then the other, so it's like basically at the beginning of this game and at the end of the first chapter, this game sets in front of you. Bravo, Ren. Bravo. We gave you a challenge. Flying colors. Flying colors. Couldn't be more proud.
Thank you. Thank you. What a shitty vehicle. What a dog shit contraption. Oh, fuck.
All right.
Hey, Patrick, let's see this score. Ooh, not very good. Ooh, not very good. Let me see those ammunition costs. Oh, it was most of my paycheck. Great.
Do you get a severance in this game?
Cool. Well, apparently I get my real one in just 6 days.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah, that is. Yeah, yes, you should be. Like, the thing that you were owed is finally maybe going to come. How delightful.
All right, Patrick.
Yeah.
Let me see what I'm working with.
Okay. Let me.
Oh God. I need to switch back to my precious White Raven V2. Actually, you know what?
What are you gonna call my boy? What did you call this? Trundlebot?
Trundlebot V1.
Okay.
I'm sure we'll get a Trundlebot V2 once I unlock more Chapter 2 parts.
Alright, so in theory,
Yeah, I believe this is the heaviest mech physically possible without reusing weapons. These are all of the heaviest weapons clicked together. Alright, Patrick.
Okay. All right. So we are going to bring up
yours.
Mine. I am going to mute your game. Okay. You can see mine now?
Yes, I can.
All right. Well, look, I'm not proud of it. Like 11:39 when I played this game for the first time, we named my pilot Patty. That's not really where I meant to go with that one. Just wasn't really thinking about it, so
yeah,
we're gonna have to come up with some new lore about Patty here.
Very good, very good. All right, Patrick, let's get into the shop.
Let me set the stage. This is not the mech that I have been playing with broadly through chapter one, which basically I was tilting. It became clear to me, hey, I'm sure part of this is not just a skill check, because Armored Core functions differently than Souls, in which Souls game, not granted, I'm sure you can beat every boss in this with anything, but
yeah,
they're in Souls, like, it is, like, by design, like, hey, like, a lot of weapons are going to be not just viable, but, like, really viable, eminently useful to beat a boss. Whereas in Armored Core, I think there are going to be instances where you're putting yourself at really distinct disadvantages that you're not going to be fully cognizant of unless you're getting in there and messing with the mech and changing it to apply to the boss that's in front of you. And so this version of the mech is basically me just like, I'm just going to try like six different weapons and like see if any of these feel good against the boss. So they don't really reflect a strategy. So we can kind of start from square one, because there's really not there's not really a story to tell, other than I was using, like, basically what I can say is that I was picking like a grenade launcher and a rocket launcher, like, to try, like, what are things that are like big heavy hits so I can try and bring down that shield a little bit faster. And that was sort of my operating theory on like what I was you can rename it if you like. No, I think I need to live with it. I think I need to live with
Patty. Yeah.
Patty. But actually, that's good to know. And then maybe I'll switch that after the stream. But I'll live with my shame here. So, where do you think we start?
All right. So, Patrick, I've got a theory on. I have a theory. I think I know the exact mech that will be what you're looking for.
Okay. Okay.
From what I know of you in my heart.
Okay. Let's go.
All right. So first, let me see what weapons you have. Okay. In your right hand.
Yeah.
You're gonna equip that little machine gun.
The Ludlow?
Yes.
Okay.
Terrific. Go over to your left hand. Okay. So, leave this menu.
We're going to the shop?
Be free of it. We're gonna go to the shop, but also go to OS tuning for me. Go over to system unlocks. Great. You have the kick. Okay. You're going to get that weapon bay, Patrick. So we're going to go do one of those little arena fights.
I did them all.
Get you that weapon.
I've already used it all.
Yes, you can reset them. You're going to reset those because you need the weapon for what we're doing here.
Okay. So I need to sell something so I can reset them.
Okay.
Sure. Large.
Get rid of that pistol. Yeah.
Okay. So OS tuning, reset, OS upgrades. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. So we want boost kick.
Yes. So go to system unlocks. Just pull up in that whole menu. Great. You're gonna get boost kick. You're gonna get weapon bay, and you're gonna get quick turn.
Okay. So I had two out of three. So that makes me feel better. That I was most of the way there. I had quick turn and I had boost kick. And then weapon bay, so this is just... Oh, it changes the kind of weapons you can put in there.
So, it doesn't change the weapon. It doesn't. Basically, it gives you a weapon swap on that hand. So now your left hand can hold either a assault rifle or a sword, and then you use the left bumper to switch between them. So if you remember when I was in the fight and I pulled the pile bunker off of my shoulder, when I I had the dual SMGs, the one bubble one and then one regular one, and then I reached back up and I pulled the pile bunker off of my shoulder, that is what weapon bays do. Mm. And so we're going to use that.
Okay.
To put a pulse sword on the left hand.
Okay.
And then the little, you're going to put that, go up one?
Pulse blade.
Great, pulse blade. Terrific.
Okay.
Beautiful. And then on your back, we're going to put the, on your left back, we're going to put the little bubble gun.
So I have to buy that. Okay.
Yes, you do. I would just say sell everything that you don't currently have equipped, and we can buy it back in a minute if we need to.
Okay.
Because there's going to be a lot of purchasing.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
I'll just sell all of it, and then we'll just.
Okay, that's fine.
Oh, sorry.
There was just two parts that we were actually going to use.
Okay. Well, do either of these?
You are going to be using you're going to use the ALUA, so the one right beneath you.
Okay.
Yeah. That little fucker right there. For your FCS system, you are going to use let's go to the store. For purchasing. Go to your FCSs. Very, yeah, perfect. So the only, whoa. Yeah, that's just a straight up upgrade with only some slight disadvantages to weight and energy, so just grab that. That's really good for mid-ranging, and kind of mid at everything else. The one that I use is Talbot, which is really good at close and medium ranges and absolute dog water at long range.
Okay.
It's really bad. But, okay, so we've got the booster, we've got the FCS system. Hop over to that generator screen, Patrick. Is that the VP200 is there, and then the Ming Tang. Okay, what do you currently have?
Can you I guess I can't show equipped.
VP2OS? Great. We're going to stick with that.
Okay.
All right. For your core, we are going to buy the, go down to the, one more. Do you not have the orbiter? Oh, you might have already purchased the orbiter.
Yes.
Yes, okay, we're gonna go with that. Great, for your arms, you're going to do the Noctreiher. No, like for your arm part.
Oh, actual arms. Noctreiher. I see. Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Perfect.
Okay.
Okay. Next, you're going to get the Noctreiher head. Oh, wait, no, you don't have that part yet. Okay. Great. And then legs are going to also be Noctreiher, which I believe you already have.
No, I don't.
Oh, wait, no, you just sold them.
I think I sold them. Great. I did have them, so.
Oh, wait. Is that the... Okay, you're taking those, Patrick. I was wrong. It's the Kazwar. The reverse-jointed legs you see right there. Yes.
Okay.
All right, sell the Noctreiher. Now that I know that you have the Kazwar, that's what we're gonna roll with.
Okay.
Terrific. Alrighty. And then now we're gonna equip. All right, so last thing we need to buy, sorry.
Yeah.
Final thing we need to purchase. Mm-hmm. We need to purchase a left arm unit, HI-16. It's the little bubble gun. Great. And then finally, can you show me your shoulder options? Just so I see what you have available to you.
I think I have everything you can get. Like, I did all the arena stuff, so...
Yeah.
And all the training, so I have more or less what you can get at this point in the game.
Okay. All right, what we're going to go with is we're going to go with the... Go down to the very bottom. We're going to go with that plasma missile launcher right there. Yeah. Great. All righty. Now let's... put it all together.
Okay. So that's the one we're keeping. And then this one is the pulse gun.
Mm-hmm.
Then this one, plasma missile launcher.
Yep, correct. And one more over. One more over.
One more over. I see. Okay, sorry.
Yes,
I wasn't grokking the... Okay.
So go over one more to the right. Yes.
And now
you're going to want to put the pulse blade. Yeah. Great. And then finally, we're going to go with the knocked head.
That's
orbiter body. Knocked arms. Those. And then go down one. Yep. And then finally, go with that. Yeah.
Okay.
So wait, was that last one? Abbott, no. And then check the generator. All right, Patrick, I want you to hop into the training mode and see how that feels.
Okay. What is the...
Just hit R1 to just hop in.
Oh, I gotcha. I see.
So how am I swapping between those weapons that are now?
It's just left bumper. See?
Nice.
Great.
So what's the advantage to having it in the front or back? Like,
being able to use it at all.
Gotcha. Okay.
Patrick, quick question.
Yeah.
Are you boosting all the time?
Like you mean this?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, you want to be doing that anytime you're moving. But how does that forward boost feel to you?
Oh, right. That's that thing, right?
It's the jump, but you also have your square. You have your quick boost.
Right. It's very fast.
Do it on the ground. It's different on the ground, remember?
Ooh. There we go.
So, when the boss does that big missile attack, like the really fucking annoying one, you're going in.
You just boost through.
You boost through, and then you go under, and then you fly up, and the missiles will try and track to the boss. We'll try to track to you and end up hitting the boss. You can use the boss as a shield for the missiles if you go fast enough and you go under it. This is probably what I would recommend as a good mix of, like, this can take out normal enemies just fine. Your pulse blade will do totally fine for the beginning part of the mission and for the first, for the mini boss. Sula, and then you should be fine. I think this is a mech that is well suited to the task.
Okay, let's give it a go.
Let's do it.
Cassarino, a bubble gun looks so silly. It does. It truly does. It's delightful. I'm hopeful that there's more of that in the game, which is just like dour, super serious Armored Core game, just the saddest boys. Just surrounded by the saddest men possible. And then, like, I hope there are just weirder weapons as the game moves along.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Patrick, don't worry.
Yeah?
That's Armored Core, baby.
Yeah, I'm just curious what that is. Like, what is the spectrum of, like, kind of strange weapons that might appear in this game?
I mean, like, you'll get the Moonlight Greatsword at some point.
Right, that makes sense.
That's guaranteed. Alrighty. And Patrick, just so you know, on my screen, I am doing this mission alongside you with the exact same build.
You're just making me sad.
No, this is not me making you sad. This is me trying to figure out what I can recommend.
Okay. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Patrick, this is not me trying to be a dick.
I know. I'm just getting, performance anxiety. I'm out. You see, usually, I've had great success. One of my favorite things to do is to stream these types of games. I've had great success. Like, for some reason, I perform better playing, like, the Souls games on a stream versus at home. I think there is something about, like, because I'm performing to a certain degree, like, in front of an audience, that I just am calmer than I will be, like, in my house by myself. And so I've actually sometimes, like, you know what? I think I'm going to do better if I'm just playing this in front of a fun crowd. We'll see if that, between that and then, I'm having to get used to switching between the weapons.
Yeah. It takes a sec.
Oops. Oh, I have to actually kill all. Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's the. You have to get everyone. Yeah.
Sometimes you don't have to kill all the people. Who did I miss?
How did that guy get down there, even?
He's scared. He's scared.
A little bitch. Destroyed. Move on to the next area.
One repair kit remaining. The animation when you do the boost is, I mean, like, a lot of visuals in this game are just, it's a lot of tiny detail stuff, but it's just so spectacular. All units deploy for combat.
Yeah, it's really incredible. I love the animation specific, like, on this specific build.
Lock that up. Okay. Yes, I'm aware I can't start from the checkpoint. I fucked it up.
Main system activating combat mode.
Someone is asking in chat, I'm so confused, so dodge is or is not on square button? It is.
Also, I like, you know, your commander or whoever is like, leave no evidence. It's like, you know, okay. real quiet mission at the moment.
Oh, evidence means bodies. evidence means living witness. This is what Walter means. My fucking enemy of all enemies, Handler Walter.
AP at 50%. AP at 30%. Two repair kits remaining.
So, Patrick, can I give you a tip for getting through this opening section without having to worry about those big cannons?
Mm-hmm.
You can just go behind. You can just go to the water behind them, and they can't shoot you. And
so really?
You just fly up behind them and take out the cannons first, yeah.
That
Every time
sense.
I do this mission, I take out the cannons, and then after that, it's just like, you know, cleaning up the villains.
It makes sense that you're starting to min-max the most efficient way, especially if you're doing the... Because how is S rank determined? It's, like, what are all the different
it's
things that
it's... It's a mixture of time, damage taken, and ammo spent. So, to get an S rank, you're looking to take a very little damage and also be very fast. It's a both and situation.
Aww.
And some missions allow you to beat the to like basically restart at a checkpoint once. I'm not sure how they calculate it though. Got this, Patrick.
Yeah, I like that enthusiasm.
I have full faith in you.
Me too.
Like, will you get it on your first try? Maybe not.
Maybe
but I
not.
Think you will
That's
get
okay.
it.
Is that Zula?
So far I've really been liking the story stuff in this game. I think it's really strong. It is the most like active I've seen an Armored Core story. In that like a lot of narrative is happening mid-mission as opposed to exclusively in briefings, which is what I'm kind of used to. But yeah, I've really been liking it. I like the mystery at the heart of it. The end of chat. I'm so fucking mad about this min-max thing. I'm very excited to be on it. I'm so fucking mad about it though, because there's a really great cliffhanger at the end of chapter one. Chapter one adds like a plot thing right at the end that I'm like obsessed to learn more about, and I know nothing about. Add.
Yeah, that must be like, have you played a game in that sort of like book club form before, where you like sort of are sitting in like, it seems it doesn't, from my experience working with you and observing you play games, like the idea of like, no, you have like a hard, you just can't get past this point and have to sit with it, is like, you're usually like in on a game going really deep as far as you can go.
Yeah. Yep.
Is that Sua?
God.
Pitiful dog. I feel sorry for you. I really do. You may have survived.
Let me. All right. Now I'm fully watching you.
C1249.
Don't be afraid of sticking closer. This is a guy who you want to be on top of. I'm a very big fan of these legs. Specifically, they're like boost dodging away from a missile that is about to like hit the ground you were just standing on, and like kicking off the ground is just like such a good fucking field game.
All right.
Nice.
Got his ass.
You damn right you did.
Lots of points. Confirmed. Enemy AC destroyed. Forget about him.
The duels in this game are very. Oh my god, Patrick! I just had a fucking idea.
Back to work.
I just had such a stupid idea.
Yeah.
This. We're both playing on PS5.
Uh huh.
This game has PvP multiplayer. Patrick,
just sort of beat me
Patrick.
Up, just like
no,
hit
no.
me on with a rag doll.
No.
Yeah.
Patrick, I will let you design what I have.
I feel like we need more parts. I feel like I feel like. So how what is the cadence? Is like every week you're doing a chapter? Is that how it's working?
No. So, well. As it stands right now, we're doing chapter 1 this week, 2 and 3 next week, and 4 and 5 the week after. I believe that's the schedule, or maybe it's bi-weekly.
Okay. Either way, like sometime in the near future, when you have more, so like I have more of a palette to work with, I absolutely love that idea.
Great. Destroy the device in the center. But yeah, and then we're still trying to determine what we're going to do about the fact that the game is very New Game Plus heavy, as all Armored Core games are.
What does that mean exactly? What do you mean by that?
So New Game Plus in an Armored Core game isn't just like you do the missions again. It's like totally or it can be totally different story content. And so like to actually get the game's full narrative, you have to do between like 2 and 3 playthrough.
Good job, 621.
But it's mostly series standard, not all of them. This game has it. Yeah! Yes, Patrick. Give in to your hatred.
You'll have to break its pulse armor to inflict meaningful damage.
Okay. So, remember to use your boost kick because it basically gives you the stagger damage of a melee attack without putting your melee attack cooldown.
And how do you do that again?
You click the left stick again. As you get close to an enemy, it puts you in like a cool little kick animation, and then you like kick off them. So like this.
I see. I mean, even just remembering that is, I was not doing that with any sort of frequency. My guess is that's gonna help a lot.
Yeah. The staggering this boss is how you beat it. Is basically by just like keeping it down. So the other thing is that like when the boss is staggered, feel free to just like sprint at them full speed, at least for a little bit, because that is like when you, that's a really good gap using time, because you have to stay really close, because right now your bubbles aren't even like hitting them
right
at this distance.
Right.
See that? That was beautiful.
No repair kits remaining.
Oops.
Patrick, do you keep touching the right stick?
Yes.
Okay, so that basically cancels your lock-on. Trust the game to, once you're locked on, trust the game to control the game for you.
Oh, that's like not what I've done at all.
Most of the time. It will do right by you in terms of keeping this guy in the center of the screen so you can focus.
All right. I'm so used to pressing the right stick, though. That's gonna take a lot of unlearning from myself.
Well, you want to lock on at the beginning.
Yeah, that part makes sense.
Don't fuck with it afterwards.
Okay. But why? Why do that way?
Keep locked on the whole time?
No, it's gonna be so hard for me to break that habit. Because that's how I control the camera. Like, that's how, like, you know what I mean? Like, normally you manipulate the camera that way, in, like, all games? So it's just, I don't know, I'm gonna have to break the habit of not doing that is gonna be difficult for me.
Basically, the other thing is that it gives you an opportunity to just, like, quickly remove your, it's basically a way to being like, okay, the reason that they have this feature at all is because like, in terms of like removing your lock on if you move the stick, is that like sometimes you do actually need to remove your lock on and like very quickly like look in another direction so you can like boost somewhere else.
Okay.
And so like it's useful that that is an option. But yeah, it is like frustrating to get used to, or like takes a sec to get used to.
No, Evany Bush, do you never use the lock on in Souls games? No, I do, but you can hard lock on, and then you can move the analog stick to adjust the camera, like the fine tuning of the camera. It doesn't break the lock on the enemy.
Main system reactivating combat mode.
Yes, it's not. Someone said this tip doesn't feel accurate to me during fights with multiple enemies. That's because it's not. If you try and change lock on while you're in a fight with multiple enemies, you'll just lock on to the next enemy.
I'm gonna keep touching that stick. I'm gonna have to work on this. This like breaks every habit I do in a video game. This is gonna be like its own unlearning process.
Yeah. I mean, the thing that's worth knowing is that like, this is new to the series as well in terms of like lock-on being the tool. It's just a way so that you don't have to like be completely clawing it the entire time. Because otherwise like having to move your thumb to dodge in some of these fights is like kind of brutal. I think that what will probably happen in the long run.
Wasn't paying attention to health. Go ahead.
I'm sorry for
I think what will probably be helpful for a lot of people in the long run, or like what people will probably do in the long run, is actually to change the game's control settings for some builds, such that basically you map the left bumper or like right bumper onto the face buttons and use those for weapon switching. And then rely on left bumper for your boost.
That makes sense.
Isn't there another lock-on in settings that's the old AC-style lock-on? I mean, yes, the game just has that by default. If you don't press the lock-on button, the game does the thing that it's supposed to do. That people are used to from older AC games.
Saw some people in the chat saying they've already used your advice to take out the boss.
Oh, nice.
That
fills me with deep joy. I love to be useful. One of the most violent Evergarden pills things I say on a regular basis. Just completely brain broken shit.
But I do see a much more viable path to me beating this boss than I did before.
Nice. This fills me with deep joy.
Because I'm getting through the shield faster, I'm getting to the staggers faster. I wasn't even just knowing about the kick boost, which like I knew it was there. I just wasn't sure as an optional upgrade, like how critical or like how useful is that moment to moment. And obviously, as you're implying here, it's like. It can be pretty critical.
Yeah, it is. It can be. The other thing I'll say is, just keep up the aggression. This boss does not like you being in its face. It likes you being far away when it can, hit you with a bunch of missiles, as opposed to in its face where you can use its body to block the missiles it's trying to shoot at you. Yeah, now this, yes, Patrick. Yes.
Ah, fuck.
All right, just heal. Remember to heal. You got this.
Damn it. It went so good. But that's the loop, right? Like, I was, the aggression, the amount of stagger, getting him in that, that is, I see what the build is doing there. And then I panic.
Yeah, also the sword, you can go, remember, you can get up in the air so fast, just go above it. Sword comes out, just get high. Oh, I'm getting raptured. Hell yeah. You know what? Let me lean in.
I'm still touching the analog stick. I can
Sorry.
I cannot. That is gonna be something. I need a zapper. Stop it. I really like the missile design of this boss. Like, there's a very, like, there's a kind of a beautiful artistry to... It reminds me of, like, Bullet Hell games.
Yeah.
Like, the way it comes out.
I mean, in a lot of ways, what you are playing is a 3D Bullet Hell.
Yeah, that is definitely true.
With the understanding that, like, you're gonna have to get hit here sometimes, and that's okay.
I think I may be hitting my stream limit on this.
Hitting your stream limit on this boss?
I think I'm hitting my stream limit on this boss.
That's okay.
But I think I will. I'm gonna take these skills. I'm gonna apply them offline. And I'm gonna take this guy down because I do really like this game, and I want to get deeper into it. I just think part of my process is going to be, like, all the stuff you just said. I feel like I'm going to be doing a lot of reading about the game and how people are playing it, and then, like, taking that back in. So, Min-Max. The first episode is recorded, isn't recorded? When
is recording on Sunday.
Is recording on Sunday. People are going to be able to check that out in video form on their YouTube channel, and then I assume in podcast form as well.
There we go.
And then look forward to Ren checking out more chapters of Armored Core 6, which of course we'll be checking in with on Remap Radio as well. And then Austin has been tweeting a lot about this game, but I think is traveling and managed to put in a bunch of time with it. It had a release. Who could say how an Austin Walker would get an early copy of that game? Wild! That's crazy. But yeah, thanks for sticking with us for this stream. Thanks for watching all the stuff we've had going on this week, which was a bunch. We had a stream attached to the brand new HOA podcast that Rob and I recorded. We have a new episode of Remap Radio where we talk to the folks over at 404 Media, which are a bunch of ex-motherboard folks. Basically, Remap doesn't exist. The stream is not here without the folks who are part of 404 Media. They're launching their own crowdfunded journalistic enterprise. So if you are interested in what we've done, if you're appreciative of the stuff we've done at Waypoint and at Remap, you have those folks to thank for allowing us to have our jobs as long as we did. Then the HOA podcast went out. We did a stream where Rob and I looked at Zillow listings for houses like within 100-mile radius of Rob, and it's bad. It's a horrible, horrible situation out there. Even if you pretend you have a ton of money, it is still a terrible, terrible situation. Next week, what do we got coming up? We'll have a new episode of sports. We'll be previewing the NFL season with the preseason games wrapping up this weekend. We'll look ahead to the start of the NFL with Rob and I. What can we talk about next week? Is there a new game out? Oh, right. Starfield. That game. Rob and I will be... Rob and I have been playing Starfield. Can't talk about it yet, but we've been recording little Starfield diaries. They're going to kind of get dropped into the podcast where we've been
fun. Talking
about sort of our impressions as we're like playing the game in chunks. And then we'll have like a wrapper for that so that you'll hear like our broad impressions on Remap Radio. But then if you want to hear us go deeper on some things that we're confused by, like as you're kind of working way through a game, there'll be that. And then we should have a Starfield stream that goes with that. And then finally, I'll be at PAX next weekend. I'm broadly not attending to do very much. I'm there to do a panel on Sunday at 5 o'clock I'm going to be co-hosting a panel about like parenting and games and technology on behalf of Crossplay, the newsletter I'm doing about parenting and games. I'll be wandering around on Sunday with my family, so be chill, but feel free to say hi if you see me and two children dressed up in identical peach costumes. We'll be on the show floor poking around, and hopefully I'll see some familiar faces at the panel itself. But otherwise, it's been a good week. Ren, thank you for beating that chonky boss with your chonky tank. That brought me great delight. That's going to do it for us this week. Everyone, enjoy your weekend. You can support everything we do at Remap Radio by going to remapradio.com. Thanks for watching. And this is me Bye. Going to the outro. Bye! Excellent. That was a lot of fun. And we should definitely, I think maybe, let's check in as you go through your, I think I still hear my mic.